these technological times, it's easy to look for limitations. But the truth is that we have never been as capable of creating as we are today. Getting to master your tools can help to identify the bottlenecks blocking the full creative potential we all possess. For so long, the laptop was giving me a lot of problems. It was lagging all the time. It was hitting a lot. This was making the editing process really, really choppy. Rather than buying a new workstation, I decided to do a little bit of research and figuring out what could be doing the bottleneck effect. Awareness. So I have some bullet points. For what I've seen, laptops have two main issues: one, cooling performance; other one's hardware performance. So the first was to open the laptop, replace the thermal paste, and also to keep the laptop as cool as possible, I got one Amazon platform, like Amazon stand, you know, these things that you put fans under it, and it fixed it up. So far, the computer is pretty fresh. I also wanted to underwall the computer, but with the thermal paste and having a good stand with good fans has been more than enough. On the other side, you have hardware. Hardware really affects the performance of laptops. Most of the computers come with a very generic 8 or 16 sticks of RAM. I found 32 sticks of RAM in Amazon, so I have now 2 32 sticks of RAM, and that makes a 64 gigabytes of RAM. After Effects is a huge RAM consumer, and pre-visualizing the composition was becoming a nightmare. It will lag, and it will start loading again and previsualizing again. With 64 gigabytes of RAM, you don't have this problem. You can have a composition pretty complex. I will still keep most of the information in the RAM, even including effects and so on. It's been life-changing. These days, I think new Dell XPS, they have the ability of handling 2 internal M.2 SSDs. So actually, that's fantastic because you can make one SSD for your operating system and your programs, another SSD for your cache memory, and the working drive for the footage. So as a bonus tip, I'm gonna give you a few tweaks you can do in your BIOS to improve the likelihood of your laptop. And I'm gonna show it to you right now. Basically, what you have to do is to switch on the computer. Once the computer switch on, you start pressing F2. Like a mad person, and you wait for the BIOS to launch. Good. So we are now in the menu, and there's so many different options here, but the only one feels relevant for now is power management. We click on it, and you will see that so many subcategories has been revealed. Then you go to primary battery charge configuration or something similar, depending on the brand, and it will reveal for different type of options or more. One is adaptive, standard, primary AC use, and custom. I personally recommend custom. That is not going to bring you the best performance, but definitely is going to improve the likelihood of your computer as much as possible. And basically this, what he does is, every time the battery levels hit 50%, start charging the battery. And when the battery hits 90, over 90%, stop charging the battery. You can configure it and do it at your own preference, preventing the battery to hit the 100% and overcharge, and keep the battery healthier for a longer time. You click apply, you click OK, and we are ready to install Windows. Everyone's needs are really, really different. So what I usually do is I install the Windows and I delete all the applications that come by default with Windows. And I then install the applications I know I usually use. Whatever you use for your day-to-day activities, just keep it as simple and as optimized as possible, and try to keep your computer with less shit as possible. I don't feel like a huge impact on that, or as much on the cooling the computer and changing the hardware, but it still is a very important thing to look around. And what else? And that's it. I think we have everything. So if you like it, please smash that like button, comment and share. If you doesn't like it, just insult me on the comments. That will be awesome as well. And again, thanks for watching.